mai separare il bianco dal rosso.
Well done, yes! The whole egg goes inside the carbonara. The most authentic version.
La carbonara ci rimane, a Roma si dice bavosa.
Bavosa, bavosa, which means like drooling.
Perché la pancetta è molto uniforme. Rischiamo di avere una cosa troppo secca che non ci dà abbastanza.
Easy, no pancetta, no bacon. At the same time, the flavors that the big chick can give you.
Okay.
Hi, and welcome to Vincenzo's Place, a place where you get to learn how to make delicious Italian recipes. And we also react to Italian recipes, made the wrong way and the right way. In this video, we are reacting to the most authentic carbonara made by the chef at Cecchino restaurant in Rome, which is a restaurant that has been around since 1887. Oh yeah, six generations. After we react to the carbonara, we are going to look at the menu of this restaurant. I've never been to this restaurant, but we will check the menu and see how authentic it is. And let's see what the chef is going to offer to us. The music.
Parliamo della carbonara.
Good thing is his accent. He's got a very strong Roman accent. I already like it.
Il sale, ovviamente le uova, il pecorino romano.
DOP means that the pecorino romano is made in a certified area. So they know where this pecorino is from and it's authentic.
E il guanciale e non la pancetta. C'è una bella differenza perché la pancetta fa parte della pancia e il guanciale è proprio la guancia del maiale. I componenti del grasso sono diversi e è diverso il rapporto fra il grasso e il magro.
Well said. Fantastic explanation.
Nice.
Guanciale is completely different to pancetta. Prosciutto is different to salami. That's an example, you know, it's different and this guy explained perfectly.
Vediamo che ha una parte grassa, una parte magra, venata e una parte grassa sopra. Allora, questo grasso è più morbido, questo grasso è più duro. Nel momento in cui andremo a rosolarlo in padella, questa parte si squaglia, questa rimane soltanto abbrustolita. Questa parte che si squaglia ci serve di base per far insaporire poi lo spaghetti.
Yeah, because we don't put oil in the carbonara, so that fat becomes the oil, the flavor of your carbonara. You don't need garlic. The flavor is in there, the guanciale already has the flavors.
La pancetta questo non ce l'ha, perché la pancetta è molto uniforme. Rischiamo di avere una cosa troppo secca che non ci dà abbastanza parte grassa per insaporirla.
Easy, no pancetta, no bacon. Of course you use it if you can't find it, but the difference is the pancetta, the bacon is too dry. At the same time the flavors that the big chick can give you.
Okay.
La pasta generalmente che si usa per la carbonara è lo spaghetto di grandezza media, normalmente il numero 5. Pasta di grano duro, questa è una pasta completamente italiana, un pastificio toscano.
Look, spaghetti, yes, it's my favorite, I love spaghetti. You can use rigatoni, mezze maniche, bucatini, tonnarelli, anything you like, okay? I agree, the dry spaghetti is perfect for the carbonara. What more do you want? It's the perfection. Using egg pasta is also okay. But you need to remember that this carbonara is made with eggs. Egg pasta, egg. It's gonna be very heavy. It's a bomb. You know, if you're a teenager, then do it. But if you're over 40, you know, it's a bit hard to digest.
E poi ci accende sotto. Dobbiamo mettere poco sale perché poi avremo componenti salati, il guanciale e il pecorino.
Very good, not too much salt because the guanciale is salty and the pecorino is very salty.
Andiamo a mettere la pasta. Ovviamente aspettiamo che si ammorbidisce la pasta e poi la mescoliamo in modo che lo spaghetto non rimanga attaccato uno all'altro.
Very important, you stir the pasta when you put it in so that way they don't get stuck.
Versiamo un pochino d'olio e del guanciale.
He's putting oil in the pan. Let me tell you, I did grow up adding the extra virgin olive oil before putting the guanciale. I did that and it's delicious. Only in the last few years I only use the oil that the fat of the pig cheek gives to me. The difference in flavors? No, not a big difference in flavors.
Nella padella di ferro e andiamo a rosolare. Dobbiamo fare in modo che la parte di grasso più morbido sta quasi diventando trasparente, mentre rimane croccante la parte più dura. Un'altra cosa fondamentale è che la pasta deve essere al dente.
The pasta must be al dente, because we are cooking the pasta in that little saucepan at the end, the last minute, and it will release all the starch that we need to create the creamy carbonara.
Fate le paste a base pecorino e guanciale. Prima di scolarle, tenetevi da parte un po' d'acqua di cottura.
The pasta water full of starch always helps to combine the ingredients. This is pretty much for any pasta, especially for the white pastas where you use the white sauce.
Come abbiamo detto, al dente. Fiamma spenta. Facciamo un po' insaporire la pasta così. L'uovo ancora non lo mettiamo. A questo punto interviene la nostra acqua di cottura. Mettiamo il pepe, andiamo a mettere un po' di pecorino, facciamo amalgamare. L'acqua di cottura che avevamo messo ci fa fare una specie di sughetto.
I find it fascinating what they did. They actually put the pecorino first, the water, so you create a kind of a base, you know, like a cacio e pepe style, before adding the eggs. Interesting.
Riaccendiamo la fiamma in modo da farla scaldare bene. Tiriamo un po' per far amalgamare il tutto. Se dovesse asciugare troppo, abbiamo sempre la nostra acqua di cottura. A questo punto abbiamo...
Pasta water is your best friend. I mean, this restaurant has been making carbonara for a very long time. They know what they're doing.
Abbiamo la pasta che è al massimo del calore, spengiamo la fiamma, prendiamo il nostro uovo, lo andiamo a buttare dentro, intero, mai separare il bianco dal rosso.
Well done, yes! The whole egg goes inside the carbonara. The most authentic version, and still, I believe, the best way. This takes me back to my childhood, you know. This is how my mom makes it, you know, she breaks the egg, or she makes the cream at the same time. Sometimes she mixed eggs, or sometimes she did this, and it's so yummy. But this is the best part now.
Perché ho spento la fiamma? Ho spento la fiamma perché altrimenti avremmo fatto la frittata. Invece così, la carbonara ci rimane, a Roma si dice bavosa.
Bavosa, bavosa, which means like drooling.
Yeah, boy.
So the carbonara, you know, all the new videos now show you to make super creamy. My carbonara, it is creamy. You can go and watch my videos. I do like to mix the eggs and the pecorino together with a little bit of pasta water to make it creamier. This is the authentic, most authentic, old-fashioned carbonara, which, as you can see in that pan, you have a little bit of scrambles. That's called bavosa. So you got the creamy, but you also have the scramble. It's not a scramble egg, but it's just a tiny bit of scramble. It's just that consistency. It's what I grew up eating. It's what the authentic carbonara is. And it's delicious. But at the same time, I do want a little bit of modern carbonara. I do want that creamy pasta when I...
Ed è pronta da mettere in tavola. Se avete una spatola, vi potete aiutare con la spatola.
So beautiful because it gets, you got the egg and the guanciale together making love. So when you eat a piece of guanciale stuck to the egg, oh, it's yummy. I have to say, this carbonara is the one that my mom used to make, which is the one I grew up and I love. It's a little bit drier, yeah?
Un pochino di pecorino e nuovamente buon appetito.
So in my carbonara, I basically follow the same technique, but the difference is I like to make it extra creamy. I do want a little bit of scrambled eggs, creamy of course. See, my point of difference is that I actually mix the eggs and mix it with pecorino cheese and the pasta water in order to make it creamy.
The parmigiano will cover the smell of eggs. Look at this. Now, what do we do now? Turn on the cooktop again. Very, very low. Very low. You can make mistakes now. Very low. Add more pasta water in there.
Normally, even me, everyone tells you, you have to switch off the pan when you add the eggs into the carbonara. The reason why in this video I'm telling you to actually switch off the pan at a very, 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 very low heat. It's because you're not a professional cook. If you have a cold pasta, your eggs won't cook in the pasta, you know? I discovered that you can actually still make a nice creamy carbonara by having the flame very, very low. And you are not actually creating scrambled eggs, okay? But you do need the water at the bottom of the saucepan, the pasta water. That will help not to get the scrambled eggs.
You know,
those eggs getting stuck on the guanciale, it's beautiful.
Minutes. And we can serve this yummy, yummy.
You know, it's
carbonara.
Beautiful. Don't look at it as a bad thing.
La pasta per me sembra pronta. Switch off now. Switch it off. Look how creamy this is.
Look how creamy. Look at that. And that's how it was done. This video, you know, the chef from Cecchino showed you that that's how the traditional one is made. So I went on their website, which is very, very, very homemade. Look how old this website is. Cecchino, Cucina Tipica Romana. Classic, authentic Roman cuisine from 1887, 6 generations, okay? So, must be pretty good, okay? So let's go on the menu here. Seasonal menu in English. And what we have, it's pretty awesome. We have appetizers, we have foot of veal boiled. I mean, this is very unique. That's already a good start. Then we have calf head cheese. Guys, you don't find this in a normal restaurant. Then we have large croutons of grain bread topped with yellow milk cheese. Bucatini alla gricia, which you can watch my gricia video. It's delicious. Spaghetti served with white sauce made with pork cheek and pecorino. Then we have bucatini alla matriciana, spaghetti alla carbonara, bavette al sugo di tonno, flat spaghetti with tuna, mezze maniche cacio e pepe, rigatoni al ragù. Guys, this is a great menu. Pasta e ceci, traditional pasta and chickpeas. I wanna go to this restaurant, I wanna try the food. It looks very authentic. So what do you guys think of this, huh? We love carbonara so much, and there is so much to learn about this dish. Such a simple dish, with such a long history and so many different techniques to follow. Well, thank you so much for watching this episode. We will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe or video reaction. Just wait for my pasta alla gricia, you will love it. E ora si mangia. Well, no, ora we react to Vincenzo's Plate. Ciao, guys.